first I've taken a Sharpie and given him a little different of a face. You can see the triangle eyes and more toothy grin, sort of like a jack-o'-lantern. Next, I drilled out the face. If you have a vise, that would be better. Pliers can work too. You don't want to hold it in your hands because you might cut yourself. It helps to drill out the eye holes first, and then I used an X-Acto knife to get it more perfectly triangular, and also used an X-Acto knife to cut out the mouth. Now, a standard LED almost fits inside the head, but if you'll notice, there's this little lip around the bottom. So what I'm going to do is cut that off with an X-Acto knife so that we don't have something sticking out. As you can see, I've cut off the bottom lip so that it's got a more straight profile. Alternatively, you could use a smaller LED that fits nicely into the head. Then I insert the LED into the head. Might have to push a little hard to get it all the way in there. I didn't have a Lego cape of the right color, so I cut one out. Next, you want to feed the LED leads through the head, through the neck, and down through the body. You'll notice I used a saw to chop off the little nub that usually comes up for the neck, because it doesn't stick into the head anymore because there's an LED in the way. So we take our head, which now has an LED inside of it, and we feed the leads down through the body. Feed the leads down, and then they come out where the two pieces of the body meet in the back.
Finally, we need a power source. A 9-volt battery works pretty well. You can get a holder to get wires coming off of it. And you'll notice that the LED has one lead is longer than the other. The LED stands for light emitting diode, and diode only allows current to pass one direction, so you want to make sure the long lead is connected to the positive terminal on the battery. So one of the terminals is marked positive. And I put a resistor in the line to make the LED last longer. 1 or 2K should work pretty well. And as an added touch, it's not necessary, but I added a switch so that it's not always connected to the battery. If you do add a switch, you'll want to get a single pole, single throw switch, which means when it's in the off position, these two are unconnected, and when it's in the on position, they're shorted, so to connect the circuit.
After I soldered everything together, I put it inside of this little Lego base to make everything cleaner and keep with the Lego theme. And I've got my switch right here. And that's it.